वेलकम ऑन ड्रेसिंग रूम की बातें मिस्टर मिलिंद रेगे. मिलिंद सर, गुड इवनिंग एंड वेलकम टू ड्रेसिंग रूम की बातें.
थैंक यू प्रसन्न फॉर दिस अपॉर्चुनिटी टू मी टू टॉक टू एवरीबॉडी एंड आई एम पर्टिकुलरली डिलाइटेड दैट मोस्ट ऑफ द ऑडियंसेस विल बी फॉर द फिजिकली डिसेबल्ड. लेट्स हैव अ नाइस चैट टुडे. थिंग्स आर टू डिफिकल्ट इन टुडेस टाइम्स, बट दिस काइंड ऑफ वेबिनार्स आर इंटरेस्टिंग टू कैरी ऑन एंड let's see what we can achieve in today's conversation.
Oh yes, absolutely. Also to introduce the other panelists who are there as a part of the discussion, they'll join us in the later part of the discussion. The patron member of the AICAPC, Mrs. Rekha Wadekar, joining us. Also Ashok Wadekar with us, the vice president of the AICAPC, Prasad Desai with us. Brijesh Solkar is there, the general secretary of the AICAPC, Saurabh Rawalia, the assistant secretary, Deepak Jadhav. Also Kashmira Jadhav joining us from, Kashmira Wadekar, pardon me, joining us from Singapore. So it will be a good panel that we'll be interacting with. So let's start our discussion here in this episode of Dressing Room Ki Baate. Melissa, we normally associate you, or in the cricketing circles, we call you as the Maidan Man of Indian cricket. How have the last 3.5 months been for you, Melissa?
Well, like everybody else, it's been a tough journey these last 3.5 months. Staying at home is not easy. But what we've done is that we've managed the time, we've gotten used to the fact that, yes, this is going to take a long time to get back to normalcy. And mentally, like in batting, or like in going onto the field to play a big game, mentally you're becoming prepared and getting tougher and tougher. What needs to be at important now is the kind of patience you need to show when all this is going on. But it's not been easy. But like every true Indian or every true Mumbaiker, we've all managed. Like the Mumbai cricket team of the past, under the captaincy of the great legendary Ajit Wadekar, we've been a very strong team and we've managed it. So as and when things ease down, we will come out with flying colors. But till then, we've got to be resolute. And till then, all of us will have to really fight it out.
Oh, yes, absolutely. We have to fight it out. And Milind Rege is a cricket who epitomizes that Khadus cricket spirit that Mumbai cricket is known for. Melissa, to start with, to share your journey that you have had over 5 decades, era when it started over a period of 5 decades, can you share with us aapki wo shuruaat kahan se hui? When did you start playing cricket in your childhood days? You took a bat in hand or a ball in hand, started playing in by lanes. If you could share those experiences with our players.
Well, like all the Maidan cricketers, or a lot of young boys in Mumbai, we started playing tennis ball cricket.
Yes.
And we played in our gullies or we played in our compounds, and there, wherever opportunities arose, cricket was the heart of Mumbai's lifestyle, really. And everybody, that's why cricket in Mumbai is so popular, because everybody played the game. And that's like every other youngster, we started on the same way, playing cricket. Like Ashok Wadekar is sitting with me, and Brijesh Solkar is sitting with me, and like Eknath Solkar did, or Ajit did, or Wadekar did, or Gavaskar did. All of us had the same journey of cricket as youngsters. Maidan cricket, gully cricket, tennis ball cricket, anytime you found the time, you took a bat in hand and bowled to each other. And that's how all the Mumbai cricketers have been born and brought up in this way.
Oh, yes, absolutely. And the names that you took, you know, Gavaskar, Solkar, Wadekar, along with you, that's the history of Mumbai cricket and the contribution so rich to Indian cricket. After that phase of gully cricket, playing in the by lanes, then came the next stage of playing school cricket, college cricket. So, what phase kaisa tha, sir, playing real competitive cricket as far as the Mumbai circuit was concerned, playing among some really good players of that era?
Yeah, what Mumbai cricket really taught you is to be competitive. And everybody in Mumbai had to fight for a place, because the opportunities were not too many. You had a failure and you'd be out. So, but the Mumbai cricketer, like you said, is a Khadus player. The name Khadus originated from somebody in Shivajipal, maybe Ramabhan Desai or Vijay Majlik or Ajit Wadekar. One of these gentlemen, the greats of yesteryears, these people coined that term. And I don't know how it originated, but it did originate from the Maidans, really. I don't know what the word kharus means. It's phonetically sounds good. That kharus means stubborn, really, you know. And the Mumbai man, because of his lifestyle, really, the hard work that he has to put in to get to work, the kind of opportunities that are very rare, you know, the that's what made the, phonetically, like I said, this word sounds very good. It's not in the dictionary at all, but that's how it picked up. And that's, it was a tough line, because anytime you went out to perform, you went out to play, you didn't get too many opportunities. The competition was immense, even in school cricket, and only at cricket is a game where 50,000 boys played. In those days, not so many, but certainly today, maybe 20,000-25,000 boys played in those days, and only 14 could play in the squad, out of which 11 could get a chance, out of which if you had one failure, you would be out. So the next man was waiting at your tail to catch it and pull it down for you, so that you know you get that opportunity. So the Mumbai cricketer generally, you know, hung on to that single opportunity that he got. If I go back, digress a little bit, when Gavaskar played his first big game in 1967, I mean, he got just one opportunity against the rest of India with Manohar Hardikar as our captain in those days. I mean, we were just 17 and 18 years old, and all the giants in the team. I may digress here and there, but that's the chat, so I'm doing it. I was the 12th man, and Sunil was playing in that 11, and we got an opportunity to play at the Brabant Stadium against a Patodi-led team. And Gavaskar failed in that game. Because after that, Gavaskar was not to be seen for the next 2 years in the Mumbai circuit. I mean, that's what competition is all about. So when we first won our Ranji Trophy under Wadekar's captaincy, you will see that Sunil's photo is not in the picture because he was not in the 15. Such was the competition. Who would ever believe that the great Gavaskar, the legendary opening batsman of our times, didn't find a place in the first 15 of a Mumbai team? So that was the competition, which every single Mumbaikar or every single Mumbai kid, right from playing from Bombay schools to Bombay University to India schools and so on and so forth, as he went up the ladder, he had to fight for survival. Just as a Mumbaikar has to fight for survival when he comes from Nala Sopara to Chesgate for work. And that continued. The number of trains that bring you, the crowded trains, you get in these trains with your luggage, your bag, you go back home. I mean, it's a day which is full of action. And that's how the struggle for survival was the bottom line for a Mumbaikar and for a Mumbai cricketer.
Oh, yes, so wonderfully said. And that's why, you know, it's always a pleasure to listen to Mr. Milind Rege, because when he narrates, jab wo batate hai, to aapko lagta hai ki bas sir bolte rahe, alag-alag jo un dino ke anecdotes the, jo cheeze hua karte thi, wo batate rahe. Yahan pe sir ne ek word use kiya, ki that's what Mumbai teaches you. It teaches you the tough life, it teaches you to be competitive, it teaches you to play it hard, and it teaches you that khadus attitude. That word is not there in the dictionary, but I think the entire world uses that to describe the kind of cricket that Mumbai plays. Then you progressed to school cricket, college cricket, then came the Ranji Trophy debut. So if you could share some experiences of being in that dressing room and sharing that dressing room with the real stalwarts of Mumbai and Indian cricket.
Well, I became a little famous these days because of my association with Gavaskar. People forgot that I played cricket. They say he's Gavaskar's childhood friend. And so they forgot that I also played cricket. But let me tell you one thing. The first opportunity that we got after performing, like everybody does, you see, at the lower levels, everybody performs, and the final horizon is getting into the Mumbai team. And that's how we got in. And who do we have in our team? When Sunil and I first saw these players, we saw them from the North Stand A block. Oh. And Sunil and I stood there and watched all these players. And the next thing we knew is that we grew up a little bit. We were 17 and a half or 18 years old. When people talk of some great players of today playing for Mumbai at 17 and 18, both of us also played when we were, I think, 17 and a half and 18 years old. So our journey has been a tough one. But those people in the team who we got to know and got to see for the first time in our lives, next to each other, physically touch them, was Manohar Hardikar, captain, Ajit Wadekar, Ramakant Desai, Dilip Sardesai, Ashok Mankad, then who else? Sudhir Naik, Umesh Kulkarni, Ekanath Solkar was our captain in school. So he and I, all three of us, were very, very close buddies. And Balu Gupte, and what more do you have? And you see these people from the stand, and suddenly you find yourself in the nets with them. And then you realize, oh God, have we arrived? But that feeling of arrival was only for that little moment. Because after that, they treated you like one of them. There was nothing to say that, come on, there was no mollycoddling for you. You had to play tough cricket. But I can tell you one thing, all these giants that I named just now took the onus upon them to bring us up in the game. My first room partner was Dilip Sardesai. Can you imagine? The great Ramakant Desai, who we had seen, followed by 1,000, 2,000 people after watching a timeshare match. You see, my brother used to play for ACC, and Sunil's uncle was Madhav Mantri. So we were in the ACC dressing room watching these players. And every time Ramakant Desai played at the Islam or Parsi Gymkhana, when the match was over, the great Ramakant Desai would walk to the Marine Line station. And I tell you, believe you me, there were at least 1,000 people behind Ramakant, fans who were after him to give autographs, to touch things like that. And those were the days. And so our first dressing room experience was fantastic, because these people really took us in their stride, and allowed us to blossom, shall I say. But they were great help. I must admit that my first game after that is when we went to Ahmedabad. Okay. And I tell you, this is an incident which I can never forget. And Ahmedabad was stiflingly hot. And we were staying in the Sardar Patel Stadium, where there were rooms at the top. And Ajit Wadekar and Farooq Engineer were room partners. And they paid extra, because Farooq was one of them who always wanted these good things of life. So he paid extra for the air conditioning in the room. And can you believe this? These two gentlemen called Ekanath, myself, Ashok, Sunil, Sushil Sanghvi, and Sudhir Naik, and all these 5-7 youngsters to their room. And they were sleeping on the beds, but wherever we got place to sleep on the floor, they said, come on, join us. Don't sleep in those hot rooms. So we enjoyed this camaraderie. We enjoyed these things. And they took us in their wing, and the love and the affection that they showed to us. And from there on, you see, it's been almost 60 years that we know each other. From 1967 to 2020, we know each other. We know each other's families quite well. And this camaraderie has lasted all our lives. Why? Because these great men of the past had no ego. They were only wanting to help the younger person. And those were the great... Well, that was the start of our cricket. And Mumbai cricketers and the teams never changed, because the selectors believed that, yes, if you are young, you are good, you must be picked. And the selectors were Vijay Merchant, Madhav Mantri, Manohar Hardikar, the captain himself was there in my first year, and Khandu Ramanekar. These were all giants, you see. So there, from there, Mumbai cricket, the way they nurtured youngsters, it became a family.
Oh, yes. So nicely said, that it became a family, and the camaraderie that they shared. And that is how these young cricketers then went on to become the stalwarts. So while you were saying that you shared about the dressing room experiences, but if you could share with our players, who experienced kaisa tha to be on the ground representing Mumbai team, with say Farooq Engineer as the wicketkeeper, Ajit Wadekar standing in the slip, you have Ramakant Desai here, you have Dilip Sardesai here. How was it bowling that first ball for Mumbai, and what was that feeling? If you could just go back and rewind the clock and share that experience with us, please, sir.
मैं आपको बोलता हूँ, मेरी पहली मैच जो थी सौराष्ट्र के सामने थी 1997 में. That time I was 18 years old and my captain was Manohar Hardikar. अजीत वाडेकर साहब स्लिप में थे, फारूक इंजीनियर विकेट्स रख कर रहे थे, बालू गुप्ते, ऑल द नेम्स दैट आई टोल्ड यू. एंड बिलीव यू मी, देयर वाज अ क्राउड ऑफ अबाउट 20-25,000 इवन टू वॉच सौराष्ट्र बॉम्बे गेम. एंड जब मैं ग्राउंड पे गया था, मुझे ऐसा लगा कि मेरे पैर ही नहीं, इतना मैं टेंस हो गया था. बट जब मेरे हाथ में पहला बॉल दिया वाडेकर साहब ने, तो उन्होंने पुट हिज आर्म अराउंड मी एंड सेड, डरना नहीं, जैसे दादे उनकी मैच खेल रहे हैं, आप वैसे ही मैच खेलो, हम लोग सब है. And that kind of confidence was amazing, you see, because great men of the past took you under your wing, under their wing, and gave us the confidence. But yes, a very tough moment tha because ek tarah ka expectation tha ki Bombay khel rahe, hum log khel rahe, and if you fail, you'll be in trouble. But that was the beginning. And after the first over, jab pehli over hum log ne kari, uske baad mein koi problem nahi. Because the Mumbai man was taught, Mumbai man had played. बड़ा एडवांटेज क्या था हमारे क्लब क्रिकेट जो था शिवाजी पार्क दादी यूनियन नेशनल हिंदू जिमखाना न्यू हेन ये जो सब क्लब क्रिकेट थे उनमें सब बड़े बड़े ये खिलाड़ी खेलते थे एज अ रिजल्ट ऑफ व्हिच हम लोग को एक वी गॉट यूज्ड टू द फैक्ट दैट वी वर प्लेइंग अगेंस्ट द बिग क्रिकेटर्स एंड देन द बिग क्रिकेटर्स नेवर एवर स्पेयर्ड अस दे हार्डली एवर टोल्ड अस वेल डन बिकॉज द वेल डन वॉज एक्सपेक्टेड टू बी समथिंग बियॉन्ड एक्सपेक्टेशन एक बात ध्यान में रखना जब आप क्लब क्रिकेट खेलते हैं और जब आप मुंबई के लिए खेलते हैं तो क्लब क्रिकेट यू हैव टू डोमिनेट बिकॉज यू आर प्लेइंग फॉर मुंबई दैट वाज द थिंग दैट इज हाउ द ग्रेट वाडेकर द ग्रेट मांजरेकर विजय मांजरेकर यू नो दिस पीपल प्लेड अगेंस्ट अस मेरे को याद है कि एवरी टाइम अजीत वाडेकर प्लेड अ मैच आई थिंक 150 के नीचे उन्होंने कभी स्कोर नहीं किया कभी दे ऑलवेज प्लेड स्कोर 150 एंड मोर एंड दैट वाज द स्पिरिट यू सी वी हैड बालू गुप्ते रमाकांत देसाई जब सामने से बोलिंग कर रहे थे हम लोग ने खाली रमाकांत को देखा था कि जब वो गैरी सोबर्स या रोहन कनाय को बोलिंग करते तब रमाकांत का पेस था बाउंस था दिस प्लेयर ग्रेट प्लेयर्स हैव डक्ड अंडर रमाकांत्स बाउंसेस सो बीइंग अ पार्ट ऑफ रमाकांत देसाई इज रन अप वॉचिंग फ्रॉम गली तभी से मेरी गली से शुरुआत हो गई आई डोंट नो व्हाई बट हल्दीघर केप्ट मी इन द गली एंड तब से हम लोग गली में फील्डिंग कर रहे थे And you know what I'm trying to say is that the yes. fear of playing such big cricket was never there because they took care of us. And when you play for Bombay, you're proud of the fact that you have played for Mumbai. As a result of which, ek alag tarah ka confidence tha, ek superiority confidence ho gaya. I mean, call it superiority because you felt better because you felt that you were better than the entire Maidan cricketers of Mumbai. That is why you're playing for Mumbai. And that was a great start. But my first match was not easy because I just got a wicket in my first over. And I bowled for an off-spinner to bowl slow. I was so tense that I kept bowling so quick in the air that ultimately Mr. Hardikar had to tell us, relax. You know? And I batted at number 10 that time. After me was Balu Gupte. So as an all-rounder, because the batting lineup itni badi thi, itne bade bade players the, but the idea of the selectors was to give youngsters an opportunity. That was the idea of the selectors.
Oh yes, sir, to give youngsters an opportunity. That was such a noble thought, and that is how they groomed cricketers. And then cricketers like Milind Rege, Sunil Gavaskar went on to reach where they reached at the end of their careers. Milind, sir, when you were saying. Spoke about the legacy of Mumbai cricket, the history of Mumbai cricket. When you were starting in school and colleges, there was an era where Mumbai cricket was the invincibles in domestic cricket. From 58, 59 to 72, 73, 15 consecutive Ranji Trophy titles. You saw them as a school and a college student. Then you played for Mumbai. Sir, if you could just tell us what kind of culture that dressing room had. Unbelievable. Looking now at 15 consecutive Ranji Trophy titles, if you could just explain our players, kya tha to be a part of such a champion team, sir.
Let me tell you one thing that you see, we had played for India schools in 1965 under the captaincy of my dear friend Eknath Solkar, and he was our leader really. You know, I must admit to you today that I've never seen a individual cricketer at that young age of 16, 15 and 16 being so confident in life. And Eki was so confident that he was the one to goad us on. Eknath was, of course, our dear friend. Sunil, me and Eknath, ever since we from 7th standard played with and against each other. So when he led us in the Bombay schools and Rajkot and Ahmedabad and Baroda, and then when he led us India schools, he was the man who gave us confidence. घाबरायचं नाही मिल्या घाबरायचं नाही आपण आहे इकडे मी आहे इकडे असं दॅट इज अ वे यूज टू टॉक टू अस आय मीन इमॅजिन 15 इयर किड लाईक एकनाथ टॉकिंग विथ सच कॉन्फिडन्स अँड दॅट इज हाऊ वी फील दॅट वी शुड एम्युलेट एकनाथ लेट मी बी ऑनेस्ट टुडे I felt that we should emulate Eknath even from those days, because he was our role model. Coming to your question of what did it feel? Well, we felt we would never lose. First and foremost, not because our batting side was so fantastic or our bowling side was decent enough, tough bowling side, but we felt that we would never lose. The entire culture of Mumbai, and let me tell you one thing, when people say today that the other teams have come up and Mumbai is still where it is, it's not that. The opposition that we had were the greats of Indian cricket.
Yes.
Salim Durrani playing against us, we had Prasanna, we had Chandrasekhar, we had Bedi, we had Venkatraghavan, we had all the greats of the Rajinder Goyal, who unfortunately passed away the other day. But we had all these greats. The batting was Chandu Bode, Nawab Patodi, Hanuman Singh, Budi Kundaran, Amber Roy, and you can name anybody and everybody. And the kind of confidence that was given to us is that they may be anybody, but you're still better than them. Can you imagine our captain Wadekar telling us, "Kai ghabrayacha nahi konala, barobar taka apan tyanchyapeksha changle ahot." I mean, imagine what you must have felt when having seen the great Wadekar from the stands slaughtering the bowling, telling us that we are better than them. That is the kind of confidence that a Mumbai team had. And the first time Sunil and I walked in the Mumbai team, we were there for that epic 324 runs that Ajit scored. Yeah. Sunil was the 12th man, I was the 13th man, and Dilip Sadesai must have, I think, scored some 190 or something like that. I can't recollect. But I remember Prasanna and Chandra were bowling and Ajit was slaughtering them. And that was a sight for us in the dressing room, because two of the greatest spin bowlers in the world were bowling against Mumbai. And Dilip Sadesai and Ajit were toying with that bowling. Imagine the kind of confidence we would get. Then also in the dressing room was Pauly Umrigar, our manager, or Bapu Narkani, our manager, my proper six from 68 onwards. And then there was Sharad Diwadkar, who was a great man. Then there was Manohar Hardikar. All these people were our role models, you see. And when we had seen them perform at that level, what more do you want? Because today what happens is that the Mumbai cricketer, the great Mumbai cricketer, doesn't even come to watch a match. As a result of it, the youngsters today don't know what the Mumbai culture is. But that maybe we can talk a little later. Coming to your question, how did you feel? Let me tell you, we never felt we would lose. And that was the kind of confidence we had. In fact, I remember the time when Ajit Naik, Abdul Ismail and I went for a little walk to Churchgate and back, when we had a batting lineup of Ashok Mankad, Sunil Gavaskar, Ajit Wadekar, Dilip Sadesai, Vijay Bhosle, Eknath Solkar. This was our batting lineup. And after that, myself, Ajit Pai, Sharad Hazare, and Paddy and Ajit, all these people. That was the kind of confidence we had, because the batting was so good. And it was imbibed in us, this whole culture. And you know why Mumbai cricket was so good? Because the culture imbibed in us was that we will never lose.
Yes.
We had never tasted defeat. So how could we ever feel what defeat was?
Oh, yes, and that's the culture that cricketers learned and then went on to carve a niche for them. Lisa, when you were speaking, you said that that is what we grew up listening to and believing, that we will not lose, we cannot lose. In these days, there is a lot of planning, there's a lot of analysis, or there's a lot of evaluation of every batsman, every bowler, and irrespective of what format of cricket you're playing. So can you share what used to be the kind of meetings or the discussions that you would have before a particular match or at the end of the day before entering the next day? Kya discussions hote the, kya planning hote the, un dino mein jab aap Mumbai team ke, a part of the Mumbai team?
Dekho, aajkal ka cricket jo hai, I wish I was born today. Because technically you're sounder today, okay? Knowledge itni chalti hai, sab information itna aata hai. Why is the world a brighter place to live in today? Because of information. Technology and information have taken a big part. Tabhi kya tha na ki, we were never told Ajit Wadekar went to toss and that is the time unhone wicket dekhi. Nobody would go and look at the wicket for hours and hours together. We were the first time hum log ground pe jab nikle tabhi wicket dekhte the. Aajkal ki technology has made things easier. At that point in time, cricket was different. Hum log 3 din ke match khelte the. दस बजे मैच शुरुआत होती थी, पौने पांच बजे खत्म होती थी। अभी अभी का क्रिकेट कैसा है ना, चार दिन के मैच होते हैं, 90 ओवर्स पर डे, सो 360 ओवर्स। इन आवर टाइम देयर वाज 210 ओवर्स। द आइडिया वाज टू ओनली विन। देयर वाज मुंबई टीम में द आइडिया वाज ओनली टू विन। देयर वाज नेवर ए क्वेश्चन अबाउट पर्सनल परफॉर्मेंसेस। कोई बैटिंग को जाता नहीं था कि आज हमारे 100 होने चाहिए या हमारे 200 होने चाहिए। आज बैटिंग पे लोग जाते थे तभी ऐसा थॉट था कि आज हमारी टीम 300 रन करेगी। एंड जो लोग बैटिंग करते थे उनकी ड्यूटी थी, उनकी रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी थी कि वो 300 रन तक बैटिंग करे। एंड देन डिक्लेयर करते थे, हाँ आउटराइट लेना पड़ता था, तीन दिन का मैच था। दैट वॉज क्रिकेट। द आइडिया वॉज ओनली टू विन। सो द कल्चर इन दोज डेज वॉज दैट प्ले द गेम, बैटिंग करो, बॉलिंग करो फॉर द सेक ऑफ अ विन। विन वॉज द अल्टीमेट, बिकॉज उस जमाने में इतनी टीम्स नहीं थी। उस जमाने में हर जोन से सिर्फ एक ही टीम क्वालिफाई होती थी। 1971 में जो रूल आया कि दो टीम्स क्वालिफाई करेंगे, इसलिए द रेस फॉर क्वालिफिकेशंस वाज ओनली वन टीम। एवरी टीम, मे बी मुंबई गॉट सिक्स मैचेस इन दोस टाइम्स। टुडे यू गेट सिक्स मैचेस में कितने इनिंग्स मिलते थे, पांच छह या सात इनिंग्स। आजकल के जमाने में 20 या 22 इनिंग्स मिलते हैं। सो यू कैन सी द डिफरेंस इन द क्वालिटी ऑफ क्रिकेट। बट हमारे टाइम का क्रिकेट जो अलग था, वी प्लेड ओनली फॉर द लव ऑफ द गेम, दैट्स ऑल। इट वाजंट प्रोफेशनल, क्रिकेट वाजंट प्रोफेशनल। हम लोग को सिखाया नहीं था, मालूम ही नहीं था, तो बात कर भी नहीं सकते कि क्रिकेट क्या था। क्रिकेट टीम के लिए खेले, क्रिकेट जीतने के लिए खेले। मुंबई का एटीट्यूड था, हम लोग सबसे बढ़िया टीम है, किसी से हारना नहीं, वही एटीट्यूड था बस। एंड वी वेंट बैक होम हैप्पी। वी हैड ग्रेट मोमेंट्स। We got an allowance of 15 rupees when you played for Bombay, 5 rupees a day. उसमें से 15 रुपया मिलते थे। आने जाने का टैक्सी का खर्चा 5 रुपये होता था, जो मैं, सुनील, शरद, हजारे और सुधीर नाइक शेयर करते थे, 5 रुपये आने का, 5 रुपये जाने का। उसमें 2.5 रुपया देने का टिप, बॉबी करके वेटर था, उसको टिप देने का था। और उसमें फर्स्ट डे को एक बियर लगाते थे उस जमाने में हम लोग, तो 5 रुपया की गोल्डन ईगल, तो 15 रुपया खलास। एंड दैट वाज द डे, दैट वाज फन, यू सी। एंड कभी कभी अजीत साहब ने तो रमाकांत साहब को हम लोग बोलते थे चलो आज बियर बियर खिलाओ सर, तो रमाकांत और अजीत सीसीए ने कुछ अरेंजमेंट करते थे। एंड वी हैड अ गुड टाइम, यू सी। दैट वाज अ फैमिली। एंड द बेस्ट पार्ट वाज गोइंग ऑन अ टूर। यूज टू मीट एट बॉम्बे सेंट्रल और बीटी स्टेशन, ऑल ऑफ अस। एक यूज टू हैव वन बोगी, फर्स्ट क्लास की बोगी थी, और वो बोगी में पूरी टीम बैठती थी। पूरी टीम के साथ हम लोग फिर अगर कलकत्ता जाना हो तो 36 घंटे का समय था। 36 घंटे क्या करेंगे। फिर वो सुरेश तिगड़ी करके थे हमारे टीम में, पिताजी बोलते थे। वो एक इतना फिश लाते थे, उसको कोली कोली बोलते, तो इतना फिश लाते थे कि पहले रात में पूरा फिश खाके यार। और हमारे मैनेजर कदम साहब थे, थोड़ी बियर पी लिए, थोड़ा विस्की किसी ने पी लिया। Or I mean, this is not for the younger, but that is how we used to do it. And then we used to play cards and fun and you know have time, good time. ऐसे जवान दिन निकलते थे। खाली एक थे पांच दिन का टूर था। Sixth day when we came home, everybody was you know very remorseful कि भाई आज खत्म हो गया टूर। And टूर में जाने का हमारे टीम में कहे पापा कारखानेस थे करके। He was a comedian. He made life so good. And Eknath Solkar obviously had this great ability to imitate every cricketer. Eknath would imitate Ajit or Sachin Rani so well that, you know, he was the life. Ashok Mankad and Eknath Solkar were the life of our team. They were the ones who would organize everything. Ashok Mankad, kahi bhi hum Gujarat jate the, to Vinu bhai ke naam ke wajah se, Ashok Mankad ye bahut bada naam tha. Gujarat, Saurashtra mein, ya Baroda mein. To khane pine pe bulate the, to Ashok aisa cricketer tha, वो बोल रहा था कि हम लोग 15 के 15 आएंगे, नहीं तो कोई नहीं आएंगे। That was the team spirit, you see. That was how all of us went for a movie before the game. All of us practiced together. We never left each other's company for the 5 days that we were together. ऐसा नहीं है कि मैच हो गया, कमरे में जाके बैठो, ये लगाओ, म्यूजिक लगाओ, बात खत्म हो गई, ऐसा नहीं था। बट उस जमाने का टाइम ही अलग था कि there were no other distractions, you see. There were no other information, technology, anything. And then, like I said earlier, I repeat, at the cost of being repetitive, we were a family. And that was fun.
Yes, sir, you are a family. And Melissa, just now when you were speaking, one thing which I would like to ask you, today, when you see your journey back and when you're narrating those experiences, Melissa, sir, aapko train journeys miss karte hai? Ranji Trophy match ke liye aap jab jaate the tab?
हाँ बहुत मिस करते हैं ट्रेन जर्नीज बिकॉज दैट वाज द लाइफ लाइफ ऑफ द पार्टी बोलते हैं ना हम लोग कि 16 जन हमारा बैगेज मैन था सुड़किया हमारा ये था फिजियोथेरेपिस्ट था मैट लेकर हमारे मैनेजर थे डैडी कदम और 15 प्लेयर्स 18 जन हम लोग एक बोगी पूरी बोगी बोगी बुक होती थी हम लोग की उसमें और कोई नहीं आता था कोई जाता नहीं था और उस समय में एयर कंडीशन नहीं था हम लोग जब पहले बार कलकत्ता गए थे तो इतनी गर्मी थी तो उस जमाने में ट्रेन में एक बड़ा ये मिलता था ट्रे मिलता था जिसमें okay. आइस भर के आता था और okay. आइस भर के और ऊपर का पंखा लगाने से वो तो जरा ठंडा होता था वो एयर कंडीशन बोलते पर उस जमाने में और कुछ नहीं था बट किसी ने कंप्लेन नहीं की किसी किसी को कुछ प्रॉब्लम नहीं था सब लोग जो ट्रेन का खाना मिलता था सब लोग मिलजुल के खाते थे और बहुत मजा आता था दोस डेज इवन आफ्टर सो मेनी इयर्स 67 टू 2000, you know, we still remember those days as if it happened just yesterday.
Oh yes. And also, Melissa, let me tell you, when you are sharing these experiences, we can see that smile on your face. That is an indication of how much you enjoyed that phase of your life. You played as a cricketer, and then it is everybody's dream to lead a champion team. Melissa, how was it to captain a champion side like Mumbai Ranji Trophy team? How was it to lead the Mumbai team?
Well, for me, it was not a good season. I'll tell you why. But at the end of it all, I went down in history as Mumbai's captain. And that is a great honor. Because I had suddenly taken ill in 1975. After 67 to 75, I played 76. And I took ill. And I was, you see, our Mumbai ki team, thi na, it never got changed. The same 15 played. I think Ajit Wadekar went for a selection meeting and came out in 5 minutes. So no selection meetings took time. The same 15 played. The same 15 had their seats in the dressing room. Nobody sat in anybody else's room, anybody else's seat. Then when we went to field, Ajit, in the first map, Ajit told us where we were placed for the fielding. After that, for the 5 years that Ajit led us, he never told us who is to field where. Oh. And imagine we all fielded in the same positions all our lives. The only thing was that we captaining the team was a great honor, but it was a tough job because the matches were cancelled. There was a riot in one of the games. Then they rained. But at the end of it all, nobody can take it away from me that I was a Mumbai captain. And I had, like I said earlier, I had come back from an illness, so I had played cricket for 1.5 years. So as from an all-rounder, I was a pure batsman. And my first stint back in Mumbai's cricket, I scored 100 against Shivaji Park. I scored 200s in the time shield. And I like batting more than bowling, really. But the batting side was so strong that when my number came after AK, that was the number I got. But all said and done, captaining Mumbai was a great privilege, shall I say, and an honor. And that can never go away. It may not be the best of success, but it was an honor for me.
Oh yes, an honor and a privilege, and also an honor for us to be interacting with you today on Dressing Room Ki Baatein. You played the game, you played it with such an illustrious list of cricketers. Then you also thought that you want to give something back to the game. And people today talk about Milind Raikya as a cricketer, but they also remember the role that you played as a selector. And even today, as the chairperson or as the in charge, there's always one person that you'll see in the gymkhanas, the maidans, that talent. So how did this kind of a trait develop in you as a personality to look for talent, spot talent? And nobody can forget that 87-88 era where you played a role along with Mr. Naren Tamhane in the selection of a young boy, Sachin Tendulkar, who played against Gujarat in that Ranji Trophy match. So your role as a selector, how did you develop that trait as in your personality?
I don't know. There were people like Naren and Ajit and Ravakant and Dilip Sardesai, who always thought well of me, apart from playing the game. I was pretty lucky that I worked for Tata Steel. I studied in St. Xavier's College and I had a fairly reasonably good degree to my name. And as a result of which, I worked in a corporate which taught me a lot. And maybe they realized the leadership qualities in me at that point in time. So my first stint as a selector was with these giants, really. You know, Naren Tamane, Ajit Wadekar, Ramakant Desai, and myself, and someday later on, maybe earlier, Sudhir Naik was there, and Dilip Sajesai was there. But the team that we had while Sachin was the captain, was selected, was Ramakant, myself, Naren Tamane, Chairman, and Ajit. And I can honestly tell you that I have, this is an interesting anecdote which I tell everybody. Hum ek baar hamara ek bahut jigri dost hai, Dr. Pratap Raut, jisko hum Kuka bolte hai, Kuka Raut. And he's a dentist. And main unke paas gaya tha for some dental treatment. And wahan pe kya ho gaya tha, ek umpire aaye the market kar karke, jo local school cricket mein umpiring karte the.
Okay.
And वो जब मैं उनको मिला, ओल्ड दोस्ती थी, और मैं तभी सिलेक्टर बन गया था अंडर 15 का चेयरमैन. आई जस्ट गो बैक अ लिटिल.
यस,
अंडर 15 का चेयरमैन मैं हो गया था मैं. एंड उन्होंने कहा मेरे को कि मिलिन कल आके एक बच्चा क्रिकेट खेल रहा है, उसका नाम मेरे को याद नहीं है अभी, बट एक छोटा सा 12 साल का लड़का क्रिकेट खेल रहा है, आप उनको आके देखो. एक फ्रेंडली मैच चल रहा है शिवाजी पार्क जिमखाना पे, और हमने उसको नॉट आउट दिया है क्योंकि हमको सब दुनिया को बोलना है कि ये क्रिकेटर को आकर देखो. एंड आई वेंट द नेक्स्ट डे टू वॉच, एंड कुका रैंग मी अप टू टेल मी दैट विलिन लेट्स गो एंड वॉच द मैच. तो हम लोग मैच देखने गए और एक छोटा सा बच्चा क्रिकेट खेल रहा था. उनके बैटिंग प्रोग्रेस में इतनी तगड़ी जबरदस्त एबिलिटी थी कि ही वॉज इजिली नोटिस्ड, यू सी, एंड दैट इज हाउ वी नोटिस्ड लिटिल तेंदुलकर. अलग ही था, बिल्कुल अलग था. सुनील कैसे था, सुनील वॉज अ हार्ड वर्किंग क्रिकेटर, जैसा एक ही नेचुरल क्रिकेटर था जो हम सबको लगा कि बहुत बड़ा क्रिकेटर बन जाएगा, और वो बन भी गए. जैसे तेंदुलकर थे छोटे से थे, एंड दैट्स हाउ तेंदुलकर स्टार्टेड हिज क्रिकेटिंग जर्नी बाय द एज ऑफ 12 और 13. एंड देन व्हेन ही स्कोर्ड प्लेंटी ऑफ रन्स, आई प्रपोज्ड हिम इन द रणजी ट्रॉफी टीम, बिकॉज व्हाट आई हैड डन इज दैट as the chairman of 15 and 17, at that point in time when Tendulkar grew up, by which time I became a selector in the under 17 and 19 also. And yes, I had decided that there's no point in these young boys playing in an age group where you're not going to develop further, you see. Ki wahi age group mein khel ke dominate karne ka, then you have to play with the bigger players and the older players. You see, in sport, there is no age. So yes, we inducted 5 cricketers from their under 15 category. No, I mean, beg your pardon, under 17 category into the under 19 category. And those 5 cricketers were Sachin Tendulkar, Jatin Paranspe, Abhijit Kale, Vinod Kamli, and
Mayur Kadrekar. Mayur Kadrekar.
That's right, Mayur Kadrekar. So we inducted him in the under 19 category, and I got a tremendous firing from the late Madhav Mantri to say that how could you do this? They are still young. You are exposing them to higher levels of cricket where they are not ready. So I had to request Mr. Mantri to say that, look, they are too good in that age group cricket. And then when they played this cricket, Mumbai won. So when I proposed Sachin's name in the first meeting for Mumbai, the other 4 selectors or 3 selectors were a bit wary of selecting him because they had seen the failure of Sunil at the age of 17. You see, and they pointed this out that we are rushing a young man into a Mumbai team which has the greats of Vengsarkar, Shastri, and Patil, and all these people there in the team. Why are we pushing him? Let's wait for him to play some more cricket. And being the aggressive character that I was in those days, I just won't take no from anybody. And I went on and on. The meeting took place for about an hour and a half. And then came the great advice from Naren and Ajit, saying that tumhara tera ghaisa sel, aapko unko agar lena hai, Sachin ko, to uska Sunil Gavaskar nahi hona chahiye. Are you prepared to accept that? I didn't understand what they meant, you see. So Naren Tamane told me that Milin, ek baar dhyan mein rakhna, किसी भी क्रिकेटर को लेना होगा तो उसको 5 या 6 अपॉर्चुनिटीज फेल होने के देने चाहिए. गिव हिम 5 टू 6 अपॉर्चुनिटीज टू फेल. इट्स नॉट वेयर इफ ही स्कोर्स रन्स वेल एंड गुड, बट डू नॉट डिस्कार्ड अ क्रिकेटर And Ajit said that, Ajit told me this very categorically, that Milind, I played at least 5 or 6 years late for India. I should have gone on the West Indies tour of 1962, which we all agree, because when Ajit Wadekar played against Gary Sobers' team at the Brabham Stadium in 66, it was at least 5 years late, because Ajit had scored so many runs for Mumbai that somehow or the other parochial interests, you call it whatever you want, Ajit was not picked. So he said that, all right, let's pick this ball because I was also played so late. Why miss out on 5 years of his if we wait for another two? He was only 15 years old or something like that. If we want to play him at 18 and 19, he will miss out 3-4 years of top-class cricket. And that is how, with the guidance of my senior selectors, we picked Sachin Tendulkar. And then, like they say, the rest is history. Itihas ban gaya.
Oh, yes, absolutely. So fascinating to listen to you, sir, where you say that the rest is history. And what a story that is around such a strong selection committee. Just to link that question, about 30 years later, a young Milind Rege had got a lot of experience as a selector as well. And a similar decision he took as the chairman of selecting another teenager by the name Prithvi Shaw.
Yes. Even there, I had seen Prithvi Shaw dominating the same way as Sachin used to dominate school cricket or that age group cricket. And when I recommended or proposed his name, of course, I must admit here that I discussed this with Dilip Pensarkar about taking, because Dilip was the chairman of the Cricket Improvement Committee of Mumbai and obviously a very senior test player of Mumbai. So I had discussed with Dilip that I'm planning to take Prithvi Shaw. What is your view? He said, Gyalas Pahili Milind, youngsters not to invite. Induct kar other teams mare karan hota hai kya ki there is not too much deadwood in the Mumbai team at the moment ani asha lokana apan halu halu will make room for the younger players. So that gave me again a lot of confidence to induct Prithvi Shaw in the team. And what happened was that when I inducted Prithvi Shaw, as usual, there was young. By this time I had become too old a selector, you know, shall I say too old, because I don't want to call myself senior, but I never ever feel that anybody and people are senior or junior. This is not in my dictionary. So with me was Jatin Paranspe, Nishit Shetty, and Ravi Thakkar. And of course, I must give them the respect that they never opposed me because of my age probably, or because of my length of my tenure, you see. And they immediately said, we haven't seen him, sir, but if you have seen him, let's go ahead. And then Chandu Pandit was a bit apprehensive about it. He said, Milind, lahan hai reko. Thoda Mumbai cha team madhe sir, school cricket madhe yedar ya khelna aani jana. So, matle Chandu, tu tala, you take him with you to play. And if you feel that in the nets is good enough, tu tala, hey, I leave the choice to you, you're the coach. And I firmly believe also that the coach must be given his team and now we shouldn't tell the coach what to play. But ultimately, the coach has the plans, you see. So, these progressive changes have helped me following my 30 years or 32 years of experience, because I had a solid background dealing with my senior cricketers in those selection committee meetings. All my life in my committee meetings were Tamane, Sardesai, Wadekar, Ramakant Desai, Sudhir Naik, Dilip Pensarkar, Ashok Bankar. I mean, imagine the kind of experience or the education that I had after sharing my thoughts with these greats. Or these grades telling me of how a selection process should be. And that is what probably has helped me in all my career as a passionate Mumbai cricketer. I failed to earn the India cap because medically I was declared unfit. Though I played a lot of cricket even after. You know, in those days, if you're medically unfit, you're gone, you're finished. There was no progressive way of looking at things. Like people would look at, if you're fit today, you're playing. It's not the age you're playing, you see. In those days, there were certain set norms for selectors. And I must say that some of them were very stubborn in the India selection camp. But having lost that opportunity, I gave all my life to Mumbai's cricket. Because honestly, that was my passion. That will always remain my passion. Mumbai's cricket will always remain close to my heart. And that is why, and I like doing it. Because it keeps me occupied. It keeps me mentally alert, you know, and things like that. So what better to do in this old age than to go watch cricket and, you know, give back to the game, like they say.
Oh, yes, absolutely. And you're giving it back so really well. We spoke about your cricketing journey, you as a cricketer, as a selector, as a mentor, as the one who always is looking out for talent, for spotting talent. But also, Wilson, one thing that I would request you to share with all our cricketers and all our listeners on Facebook is the importance of being also professionally aware, being educated, because you had such a top successful corporate career as well in such an established conglomerate of repute as far as India and the world is concerned. If you could share something about that, how did you manage to balance your passion and your profession as a top boss as far as corporate communication was concerned?
You see, in our times, we had to go to school and we had to go to college. At the end of it all, the foundation with a college degree was extremely important because there was no other form of cricket in our time other than university cricket. The stepping stone to playing Ranji Trophy cricket was only university cricket. So one had to go to college, and maybe Sunil's mother was greatly responsible in bringing us up together. I still remember the time when we played for India schools and AK was our captain. AK finished. He finished his school cricket, and we were 1 year younger than Eknath. So we got this opportunity of playing for Mumbai schools, and we were to go to England in those days with the India schools team, the first ever journey, first ever tournament to play. And we were doing our finals for the leaving certificate. And I was the captain and Sunil was the vice captain, proposed, not announced. And Sunil's mother said, no, you cannot go and play cricket in England when you got a school exam coming up, the matriculation final exam coming up. So we had to give education a priority. Today, tell me which cricketer is going to college. And one of the reasons for that is that age group cricket has become so important now that people don't go to college. People are only playing the game and only 14 get in a team. And that is why college education helped us a great deal. Also, there were cricketers who rose to great ranks. Ajit Wadekar became a director in the State Bank of India. Sharad Diwadkar became somebody big. And all of us, and I was lucky to work in a company called Tata Steel because my background was economics and statistics. And so a luck factor also played a lot in my career because I wasn't lucky enough. Can I carry on?
Yeah, please, sir. Please.
So, luck factor was not very, very helpful to me in my cricketing career, though I played a lot of cricket. But my professional career, God gave me that opportunity. And I worked for a company called Tata Steel, where at the age of 29, I was told by the directors, and to say the least, it was Mr. J.R.D. Tata and a gentleman called Mr. Sabawala was my vice chairman, who said, now, how many more years of cricket are you going to play? Because if you're not going to play for India, I think we've got a slot ready for you to take responsibility. And that very day, at the age of 29, can you believe it, I retired from cricket. And it was a godsend gift to me because, you see, at the end of it all, you must do the right things at the right time. You must have the right opportunities because if you miss that one opportunity of scoring 100, then you will never be looked at again. Similar things happened to me in my professional career, that this came my way. I stopped cricket that very next day and I became a professional in Tata Steel. And then as I worked, first I worked in the operations department because statistics was my subject. But later on, the company established a department called the public relations. But later on, the name nomenclature changed to corporate and financial communications, of which I was made in charge. And cricket helped me because I had traveled a lot. I knew a lot of people. My communication skills were reasonably good because of my educational background, St. Xavier School, college, and that's what helped me. But I did concentrate on my work a lot. I went to work at 8:30 and I left office at 7 o'clock. But in those days, let me tell you, every cricketer did that. Otherwise, there are so many cricketers. Wadekar was the cricketer to rise to the highest echelons in his organization in a professional career for sportsmen. But we also rose because it was imbibed in us that you have to work. You have to, because after 30 days, for the next 30 years, what do you do? So everybody went to office, everybody worked in office, and they were not idle in their careers. So which is very sad today. And you know, when an opportunity comes, you must do it. But cricket is a different game today. Cricket pays you well. Cricket helps you to establish yourself. And what I always say that how many does it allow to establish? Not too many. Just those handful who play. But everybody nowadays has an ambition. And to my mind, you cannot pick cricket as a career. I keep saying it. You play the game hard. But if you forget the other aspect of cricket, and if you are not successful at that game, then what happens is nothing but frustrations. The next 30 years of your life is what you need to take care of. But in my case, I was simply at the right time, in the right place.
Oh, yes, absolutely. At the right time, at the right place. So wonderfully explained. I think it's sabhi ke liye itna important hai, the importance of managing both things, but the importance of education in life. After your game finishes, you need to fall back on some. Before we conclude, and before I invite the panel, one question to close this discussion. Today, if you look at the Indian team, you have Ajinkya Rahane, Rohit Sharma, Shreyas Iyer, Prithvi Shaw, Shardul Thakur, and other cricketers who are there, who are making it to the Indian team. Sir, your assessment of the current Mumbai setup and the road ahead in the years to come?
I once again want to reiterate that it's high time that the Mumbai Cricket Association doesn't all the time aim on winning the Ranji Trophy. And that has been our bane, really. You see, we want to only win the Ranji Trophy. We need to develop cricketers. And what is happening is that we are not developing decent cricketers because the entire focus has shifted from people who looked after the game to people who are still not experienced enough to run the game, you see. And that is what needs to be done. Mumbai cricket is a lot. Look, at least 5 to 6 of our cricketers are playing in the India circuit, either at, say, maybe the one-day T20 test cricket. So there's no dearth of talent. But we must have the right people appointed in the Mumbai Cricket Association, maybe be it a coach, maybe be it a mentor, or maybe trainers, physios, whatever. We need to appoint the right people. And also said and done, the opportunities that come now to the Indian, to the Mumbai cricketer, is far too many that came our way. So then the cricketer's feeling is that aaj score nahi ho gaya to kal ki match hai, kal nahi score ho gaya to parso ki match hai. And as a result of which, and we selectors have also become a bit lenient also, because we believe that a long rope should be given to them. So if all these things fall together, and if there is a will, there is also a way.
Oh, yes, absolutely. Where there's a will, there is a way, and definitely we'll find a way. We have a panel. Let me invite them one by one. Firstly, may I invite Brijesh Solkar to join us and say a few words. Brijesh, sir, if you're there.
Yeah, I'm here, Prasanna.
Yes.
Prasanna, you see, I mean, you know, my association with Regis obviously goes way long, long back. You know, I mean, he's been more of a, you know, family friend to us. And rightly so, because, you know, dad's career, you know, Sunny uncle and Regis's career basically started at the same time. You know, I mean, they were together at the camp and, you know, in the Gymkhana. And basically, they were like the three musketeers. You know, I mean, they had so much of stories amongst themselves, you know, to say. It's part of, like, you know, cricket folklore. So, you know, I mean, and there are empty number of times, you know, when dad was around at home and whenever, you know, a cricket conversation used to come up. So invariably it figured, you know, Sunny uncle and, you know, Regis's names in it. So, yeah. And so, you know, and trust me, Prasanna, today's session, you know, I've been sitting here with goosebumps, really. I mean, you know, listening to these old, you know, stories which Regis shared. You know, it's been, you know, I was always aware of it, but then, you know, the other people, the other players who have been listening to it today, I guess, you know, they need to understand, because, you know, for these guys, you know, they took so much of you know, fun in each other's performance. You know, I guess that's the reason, you know, they are so successful, you know, today. Because you need to be happy for each other, you know, in at times when, you know, if you're down and the other player is performing, you still need to be happy for the other guys. You know, there was so much of bonding in the team, so much of unity. Cricket was played in a very ruthless manner, yes, but then they had their, you know, fun moments also. So we need to understand that you need to play the game the hard way, but then you also need to have, you know, that kind of, you know, bonding off the field. I guess, I don't know, but it doesn't happen so much today. I mean, you have I mean, but earlier, I guess it was the norm with all the, you know, Mumbai teams. And for me personally, I was very fortunate that, you know, when I played for Bombay under 15, under 17, you know, Regisser was, you know, part of the, you know, selection committee. So, you know, so thank you, you know, sir, you know, for sharing your experience story with all of us. Thanks a lot.
Thank you, Bridge. It's such a pleasure to hear you, because I want to tell a story over here that Iggy was the prankster in our team, really. And every time Sunil batted, he would tell the entire team in the evening over a glass of beer that, "I'm telling you, gentlemen, this lad will come up." You would have a laugh, you see, because Iqbal would always say to Sunil, "Ah, you're going to come up. You've got the talent in you, Sunil." And everybody, that was Iggy. He lightened up things so much. He was a dear friend. We went by bus together. We ate and slept in each other's houses. And that those were great days. But these are memories which will never be forgotten. You know, I remember Rekha Tujagar Ekda Aloto, when Ajit gave us, when he was staying Gute Maite Shivaji Patla, or Kacha Adipan Prabhadevila, when we were there, he used to come to your house, you know, he used to cook for us, we used to have lots of fun. And we went to each other's house, families met. I don't know whether it happens in modern day cricketers, but that is why we every time we meet, I want to say something here about Ajit also. That every time when Ajit walked into a party, when we met, Sunil and I never ever sat down till Ajit sat. Never. Because that was the respect and regard we had for him. And that was the affection we had for him. Let me tell you that. It was affection. And Ajit would always say, "Are kuthe basto re, ikade basa re tumhi dekho." So we would sit next to him. And these great players, you know, Sunil, Ajit, Dilip Vengsarkar, all these players have never ever spoken about themselves. I have seen Ajit Wadekar demolish attacks. You know, I have seen him slaughtering the greatest bowlers of the world. But they never spoke about... I do understand that they need not speak about themselves because the world is there to talk about them. But to go on record to say that Wadekar, probably no. Wadekar was India's greatest captain. There is a lobby which doesn't say it. There's a lobby which doesn't want to say it. But we, the Mumbai boys, will always go on record that Mumbai won only because of the leadership qualities of Ajit Wadekar. Ajit Wadekar was a player's captain. How many are captains are player's captains? You tell me. Because we always felt that you had to perform for Ajit. You didn't have to perform for Mumbai alone because you had to perform for Ajit. एवढे वर्ष आम्ही मॅचेस खेळलो अजितनी आजपर्यंत कोणाला मला वाटत नाही रेखा अजितनी कोणाला आयुष्यात फायर केलं असेल isn't it? He mustn't have been angry with anybody, but that was his temperament. When cricket creates character, म्हणतो ना तसं आहे ते. When he batted, he was cool. When he finished his cricket, he was cool. And in our private lives, he was cool. So that was it. And that is what these great cricketers of the past were. A happy family, great camaraderie, and friends for life.
Oh, yes. Friends for life. We speak about the late Ajit Wadekar. And we have Mr. Ashok Wadekar, also Kashmira joining us. Rekha ma'am, is there anything that you would like to contribute to the discussion? Ashok sir?
Are you here?
Yes. We can hear you, Ashok sir.
Can you hear?
Yes.
We can.
Milind. Ashok, so nice of you to give your experiences.
Ashok, boy, turn.
Come, Karu.
Turn.
Sorry? Okay.
Ball, piro.
Yeah, it's better.
Okay. Milind, what I feel and I believe that in the childhood dress, first dressing room is our home. Isn't it? Where yes. We learn how we get attached to the sports or anything, if we learn from our parents or our brothers and whatnot. Two of us are very fortunate that in childhood, I think I it's okay. Can you hear now?
Yes.
That I had Ajit as my elder brother, And in your family, the late Sri Sharad Diwadkar, the greatest off spinner Bombay had that time, really. Unfortunate, he couldn't play the test cricket. But that was the thing. And top of it, you had the best friend. Your school colleague was Sunil. So wonderful things. You know, I will tell you, you were saying how your elders were senior cricketers were helping the youngsters. I tell you the just one incident. We had a small compound and we used to play cricket. And there was one tile was broken. And if I bowl on that tile, pitch on that ball, Ajit used to get out. So he told me, Ashok, you have to pitch it here. But there was one hidden thing is there, that he was playing with the right hand. Not with the left hand. But still that is there. And I tell you, when I started playing for Shivaji Park, Ramakant, such a great person, never had any egos. He was so helpful, always. He used to give a special preference to me and Prakash Vastav. He used to tell, your first ball has to be on the stumps. When you start, you have to bowl your first ball on the stumps. And I really tell you, that was a great learning from them. It's so good. The things was really different those days. As you say, now people have, players have become so professional. But that was not the case those days. We do not have this much of technology, as you also say. But what I want to ask you, you see, we started cricket from a small age. So what was your discussion in the tent? Then we qualify to clubs and then qualify to Ranji Trophy and then thing. And lastly, you were the manager for the World Cup series 2011. What was the experience that time you had? And how you these top cricketers were behaving or communicating in the dressing rooms? That could be the best thing. And in fact, Sharad Diwadkar was the Ajit's best friend on and off the field, always. They were the colleagues, I know. So therefore, I know the things, how great he was. I'll tell you one story about Sharad Diwadkar. We were playing Kanga League and he was playing for United Club. And Paddy was bowling on the right, 2 overs were left. And you know, Kanga League, Shivaji Park, there is plenty of grass. So I took a catch on the backward short leg. And we all walked, umpire gave me out. And then Jimmy called me while going to the pavilion. अशोक तू खरंच कॅच घेतला का म्हटलं सर मी खरंच कॅच घेतलाय तर ते म्हटलं तुम्हाला एका वेळेस गवतामुळे दिसला नसेल तर व्हॉट इज इट यु नो सो एनकरेजिंग थिंग अशोक मला तुझ्याकडनं खरंच पाहिजे होतं आणि तू जो खरं बोललायस तर आय ऑलवेज बिलीव दॅट गिव्ह यू सो मच ऑफ कॉन्फिडन्स रे व्हॉट यू वर टॉकिंग दिस पीपल वर गिव्हिंग is really that was the nice thing. I don't know, I nowadays I don't go to any what you call the dressing rooms or what, but how the atmosphere is there, maybe in a professional manner the atmosphere could be there, but this was the great thing. The passion was there and nothing except what you used to play for passion, and you get a good job after your education is finished. That was the thing. My boss was, I tell you, as you narrated, my boss was Divecha, Ramesh Divecha. And then he called me, you know, after, say, it was somewhere in 1978. As rightly you said, around 20-30 years. He asked me, Ashok, what are your chances in the Indian cricket or in the Ranji Trophy? But nil. Then would you like to concentrate on your job? Of course. Then I tell you, finally, when I retired, I became the head of the papers purchase department. That was the thing was earlier. Today, I don't know what is the situation in Mahindra, but people used to take care of the younger generation. That was what I wanted to tell. And so, this is what Ajit also told me when I asked him, Ajit, how what is wrong in my batting? He said, don't ask me. Go and watch the matches. You will run more from watching the game and because the game shot I can, on which ball I can play, you may not be able to do that. So that was the thing. In the on the spot decisions you have to do. So what the best thing is, go watch and play the game. And you people had really had a great opportunity to watch the people. They were the greats like Ajit, then Patodi, and then Jaisima. You name it, and they are there. The Sunil is a prashna. I mean, so Yoda, he is a superb player. I tell you, in world, he is I consider him in the world best opening batsman. I have plenty of arguments on this. I fight with the people. But the way he used to bat against West Indies, and at that age, was unbelievable. Without helmet, without any supporting gear. So it was super. And you are lucky to have his friendship all along, right from the childhood. It was a great thing. Sorry, I disturbed you. You tell me about your experiences when you were manager on World.
Always, Ashok, always good to meet you, because that sense of humor that you had when we have a drink is terrific. Coming to this question about, I wasn't the manager of an Indian team. I was totally in charge of the World Cup in India. You see, okay. I was the general manager, BCCI, after I retired from Tata Steel, appointed me because the ICC wanted some senior person, having been in the corporate world, to be involved in India, to be in charge of the World Cup, the logistics and everything that went with it. So that was a terrific experience for me, because organizing 48 matches in India wasn't a joke. Not that it has been used by the Mumbai Cricket Association ever again, because that's for different reasons. But the fact is that was a great experience. And I'll tell you one thing. One of the things that I taught, you were just now mentioning about Sharad Divarkar. Obviously an outstanding cricketer and a great human being. So I want to mention over here today that Sharad Divarkar has been my backbone. He is my brother-in-law. Maje mevne ahet te sagale theek ahe, pan maje mitra pan hote te. Ani Ajit, Sharad, mala ajun aathavto mi jeva 11th kiwa first year la asayacho, तेव्हा मला हे सगळे स्टेट बँकला बोलवायचे जेवायला. कारण त्या 11th नाही, टाटाज मध्ये मी जेव्हा लागलो फर्स्ट इंटरला तेव्हा. आणि शरद, बुधी कुंदरन, हनुमान सिंग, बाळू काका गुप्ते आणि हे पाच चार पाच लोक होते. दीज पीपल इन्व्हाइट यूज टू इन्व्हाइट मी फॉर अ लंच वन्स अ वीक ऍट द स्टेट बँक ऑफ इंडिया हेडक्वार्टर्स. अँड देयर टू बी अन ऑफिसर्स मेस. And what pomp and style there is to be arrogant, to sit and listen to them talking on the game was a great experience. Coming back to Sharad Divarkar, I'll tell you, he retired in 1967, just when I was picked. I know he wanted to favor his brother-in-law, but I wasn't bad either. But look at the way people were. They made room for younger people. Like you said, Ashok, Sharad Divarkar was probably a fantastic. I mean, he was a better bowler than Prasanna in those days. Yes. But somehow or the other, it was a process that if 5 Mumbai players played for India, the 6th, 7th, 8th would not be looked at all. Thus has happened the same thing in my case. Because the first 5 or 6 were still Eknath. And then after that, myself, Paddy, Abdul Ismail were never looked at. Coming back to the experiences of Maidan cricket, I think like you said, Ashok, we played our cricket to enjoy ourselves, really, isn't it? Nothing more than that. And that is why the camaraderie remained. And that's why we are where we are. But those were the good days of cricket. Today, life has become more mechanical, more ambitious. Like they say, money is the root cause of all problems. And all said and done, there are no jobs left anymore for people. So they had to work at a living to play cricket. But those days will never come back. But appreciating the fact that Shivaji Park, Tumi Sagale Hota, the Dadan and Shivaji Park match had 10,000 people watched. Ashok, if you remember, Eka ground over 10,000 loka match. Can you believe it? Those were the days of great cricket because Shivaji Park had such a side. Sudhakar Adhikari, my God, what a great cricketer he was. Sudhakar Adhikari, then Vijay Manzrekar, Haldikar, Bondre, Ramakant, Paddy, Ajit Wadekar, Balu Gupte, my side aside, my God. Unbeatable, impossible to beat them. तसे दादरांची पण आमची चांगली टीम होती पण नथिंग कम्पेअर टू शिवाजी पार्क. दादर वॉज अ गुड नंबर टू टीम टिल ऑल दिस पीपल रिझाइन एंड वी टूक ओव्हर. देन वी बिकेम अ गुड टीम फॉर 5-6 इयर्स अंडर वासु परांजपे. बट क्लब क्रिकेट वॉज व्हेरी गुड. हिंदू जिंका वॉज अ स्ट्रॉंग साइड यू नो व्हेन ऑल दिस पीपल प्लेड. एकनाथ, अशोक, बुरी कुंदरन, दिलीप सरदेसाई, हे सगळे मोठे मोठे प्लेयर्स होते. त्याच्यामुळे क्लब क्रिकेट एवढं होतं. आणि आपण जेव्हा व्हेन वी टू प्ले क्लब क्रिकेट अशोक ऍट द मैदान्स, all that we did was enjoy cricket. Na? Did you ever hear anybody ever swearing at anybody? Nobody. Did you ever hear anybody sledging? Nobody. You know? No. That's what cricket was all about. You play the game, you enjoy it, you go home. That was it. And that's why I think we were happier cricketers. Today, nobody in if you see a cricketer on television today, that the first wicket has fallen for 300, the way they behave is if they've got the whole team out for 30. And that's a joke. Yeah, it's a batsman is out for 210 runs and you're still pumping fist and jumping in the air and things like that. Prasad played for Mumbai with him. Prasad was one of the major Shivaji Park bowlers. I saw him. Ramakant was extremely fond of him because Prasad was a classical side-on bowler. I mean, there was competition in it, but to play for Bombay in those days was no joke. And I'll tell you one thing. Those who didn't play for Bombay were unlucky. There was a bowler called Bharat Narvekar who was probably the best seam bowler in Mumbai of our times. But he never played a single match for Bombay for reasons unknown, you see. I played for Bombay. They were probably much better cricketers than me. But I played for Bombay because I got an opportunity and I cashed in on it.
Yes.
There were people who didn't get an opportunity. So how can they cash in on that? But you have to cash in on that opportunity. But the brilliant youngsters in my time for Bombay was led by Ekanath, followed by Sunil. Ashok, of course, was our senior, many, many years our senior, though he was only 4 or 5 years older than us. But these were the two people who the world looked at, Ekanath and Sunil, to do great things in international cricket.
Oh, yes, absolutely. Such wonderful experiences there shared by Subhendra Rege. You took one name, Prasad Desai. We'll invite him as the Vice President of the AICAPC to express his experiences and also the vote of thanks. Prasad, sir, over to you.
Prasad,
thank you, everybody, sir. Thank you for joining us and giving such a wonderful narration and speaking to the boys. Main mera experience bolna chahunga in short. Main college ke liye cricket khel raha tha. Ek semi-final match thi Shivaji Park mein. Aur sir, main bahut late shuru kiya, to mere ko naam ज्यादा मालूम नहीं थे. हाँ, तो गणपति का मंदिर है वहां पे, बंगाल क्लब पे सेमीफाइनल चल रही थी. मैच वाज वेरी क्लोज टू द टेंपल एंड आई वाज बोलिंग फ्रॉम द टेंपल एंड इट वाज अ मैच वेर यू नो आई टुक अबाउट 7-8 विकेट्स एंड वन जेंटलमैन कम्स विद अ फॉर्म इन हिज हैंड. साइन कर है, ये साइन करो ये फॉर्म. बोले सर क्या है, you're joining Tata's from tomorrow. So this man has turned over our lives. The culture which he has given us about selection and cricket ke bare mein jitni honesty hai hamare mein, wo Milind Rege sir ke wajah se. Aur sir ne इतना इन्वॉल्वमेंट दिखाया होगा क्रिकेट में या फिर सिलेक्शन में या फिर हर चीज में, मेंटरिंग पीपल या फिर ही वाज लाइक अ फादर हु नेवर स्कोल्डेड टू अस ऑन अस. हमेशा बोलते थे कि ये सही करो, ऐसा करो, वैसा करो, कंधे पे हाथ डाल के समझाते थे, इप्रेस ये सिचुएशन में मैच है, कुछ भी कर, मैच जिता के दे. और जो टीम मैन बनाने में मिलिंद सर ने हमको सिखाया है वो ही आज हम हमारे लाइफ में, आई फॉलो मिलिंद सर लाइक माय फादर, कि मिलिंद सर ने जो सिखाया है वो मेरे ख्याल से हर क्रिकेटर ने समझना चाहिए एवरीवेयर इन द वर्ल्ड, कि सर जो क्रिकेट के लिए जो देते हैं और हर ग्राउंड पे, जब पृथ्वी शॉ की बात निकली है तो सर ने 11:15 फोन किया, आई वाज अंडर-19 सिलेक्टर एंड पृथ्वी वाज देयर, इप्रास व्हाट डू यू थिंक, इज ही रेडी? सर रेडी है, अभी नहीं तो कभी नहीं सर, नेक्स्ट डे ही वाज देयर। तो वो कभी जूनियर सीनियर नहीं भेदभाव रखते हैं, वो इंस्टिंक्ट पे काम करते हैं, और उन्होंने जो बंबई क्रिकेट के लिए किया है मेरे ख्याल से कोई नहीं कर पाएगा। और सर थैंक यू वेरी मच फॉर बीइंग अराउंड एंड प्लीज बी अराउंड विद अस, प्लीज बी अराउंड।
थैंक यू ब्रस, थैंक यू फॉर दोस काइंड वर्ड्स।
Thank you so much. Thank you so much, Milind Rege sir. It was a pleasure talking to you, pleasure interacting with you. Thank you so much. And thank you to all our listeners as well for tuning in. We'll meet next weekend, but we'll say a big thank you to Mr. Milind Rege for his time and such wonderful pieces of information that he shared, anecdotes and examples, and his guidance will always be helpful for all the Divyang cricketers. Thank you so much and have a great evening ahead. Good night and see you next weekend. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.